Hey everybody, it's your boy Mike Jones, and I'm back again with another interview for you guys on uGospel.com. Right now on the phone I have worshiper, singer, songwriter, the one and only Mr. Todd Dulaney. Todd, how are you, man?
Hey Mike, what's going on, man?
I'm good, can't complain, you know, living. Alright, so the last time I saw you, I believe, was during the Stellar Awards weekend at the Celebrity Basketball Game. What have you been up to since then? That was way back in January. So what's going on with you now?
Well, man, I've just been grinding it out, man. Since then, I released my album, Nationwide, Pullin' Me Thru. And so off of the album, I've just been traveling and really just spreading that sound and spreading that album. So it's been a nonstop going for me.
Pullin' Me Thru, that was your second album, right?
Well, it actually was my first album, and what happened was Universal Fontana, they picked it up and re-released it nationwide. And so we released it, you know, the first time we released it back in November of like 2010, I would say. And then Universal Fontana grabbed it, and they said, man, we want to release it. We want to give you national distribution on it. And so they put it in stores just this January. And so I've been traveling and really continuing to sing Pullin' Me Thru, No Other Name, and all the songs on that record.
Okay, so before you were signed to Universal Fontana, were you independent?
Yeah, well, I was with an independent label, Gold Street Gospel. They're out of Chicago, Illinois, and it was founded by a guy named Bruce Spann. And he gave me the first opportunity to really share that music. So before that, I was with an independent label.
Okay, and this is the album that you were nominated for Best New Artist at the, I believe it was the 2011 Stellar Awards. It was 2012.
2012, I was nominated for Best New Artist on this album, yep.
Okay, so you already knew that, you know, some people get nervous when they release the album, you know, they don't know how it'll be received, but since you were already nominated for Best New Artist for this project, you kind of knew that it would do good.
Yeah, but you know, you still get nervous anyway because you know it's people out there that haven't gotten a chance to hear what it is that you do or what it is that God is doing in this ministry. And so I was nervous all over again because it was the first time that I had ever seen myself in stores nationwide and everything like that. So it was a first time, and it was like excitement all over again for us.
What's that feeling like? Because, you know, I've read that you discovered your singing talent as an adult recently. You know how some people have been singing since they were six when they were in the choir at the church. But you recently started singing. So how does it feel to put your project out, then you get nominated for Best New Artist, and then you see you get a national distribution deal and you see yourself in the stores? Like, how did it feel to take all that in?
Man, you know, each level is crazy because, I mean, it's kind of like an unbelief. You don't really know how to believe it because, for me, like you said, I found out that I really had a gift to sing on this level late in life. You know, I knew that I could kind of tinker around and sing around, play up on the piano, but I didn't know I could do it nationwide. And so as people begin to embrace it and whatnot, man, it's unlike anything you'll ever, you know, be able to understand because it's just like, man, you can't even believe yourself that people are actually listening to you in their homes all across the world, or people are walking into their Best Buy and they're able to see your face and see your name, man. It's something that is surreal that I'll never be able to explain the first time I ever saw myself in the store.
Yeah, because I did an interview with Michelle Williams about last year, and I think I asked her who was in her iPod right now, and the number one person she said was Mr. Todd Dulaney. So,
wow.
Yeah.
See, I have to kick her down for that, some money.
Yeah, I know you guys are both from the Chicago area, right?
Yeah, she's a, man, I mean, great person. I've worked with Michelle and love her dearly, man. Like, she's a real friend, and she's really encouraging to me in the business.
Now, let's talk about the project, Pullin' Me Thru. How did you even come about naming your project Pullin' Me Thru?
Well, I got a kind of a testimony that not a lot of people have. Before I began to sing and travel and minister the gospel, I was formerly a professional baseball player with the New York Mets. And so when the New York Mets released me, I really didn't have a clue of what it was I would do next. And so I was like lost and didn't know where to turn. And then that was when I really found a relationship with Jesus Christ. And that whole title, that whole concept, Pullin' Me Thru, was actually what happened in my life. When I was at a point where I thought that, man, I don't have any other talent. I don't have another gift. I don't know what else I'm going to do. you know what I mean, to provide for a family or a wife, you know what I mean? I didn't know what I was going to do, and then God revealed to me that, you know, he had given me a gift to really lead people in worship and sing, and so the whole concept, Pulling Me Through, came into effect then, and from there, the song Pulling Me Through, and then the album just surrounded that song.
Now, now that you are a songwriter, did you write a majority of the project?
Yeah, I wrote 9 out of the 10 songs on the Pulling Me Through album.
Okay, so where do you draw your inspiration from for the message behind each song?
Well, man, that's kind of funny you ask that. My inspiration is really, first and foremost, I'm a big believer in unity. So I believe that, like, if you can get a mass of people to sing about the power of Jesus Christ together, I believe the power of God will fall into place. You know, I believe that God dwells in unity. So when I write music, I write so that people can sing the songs. I try to keep it as simple as I possibly can. That's why you hear, like, at the end of Pulling Me Through, he'll never walk out on you, no, never, no, never. And we just keep chanting that, saying it, because I just believe if you can get a great mass of people to declare the greatness of God, man, you're in for a great time. And so that's my my inspiration, first and foremost, is to write songs that the body or a mass of people can sing together to the glory of God. And then I really, really enjoy country music. So I pull from country music as well, as far as their sound and the clarity of their sound, and then their heartfelt lyrics toward, like, the one they love.
Country music, the one that they love is usually a spouse, but of course, yeah, the gospel, you know, the one that we all love, of course, is God.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I take that and use that. Use that for our event.
Yeah, good formula, good formula. usually I ask people what's their favorite song off of their album, and nobody ever answers. Like, usually, like, 1 out of 30 people will answer that. But now I'll switch the question to, which song do you enjoy performing the most while you're touring or at an event? Or, you know, which song do you usually get the best response from the album?
You know, the people know Pulling Me Through the most. But the one I enjoy ministering the most, and the one that I believe gets the biggest response in an atmosphere, is a song called My Everything. It's a love ballad, and it seems like every time we go somewhere and sing that song, man, the power of God hits that place. And so that's the song I enjoy, because I've grown accustomed to expect a move of God when we sing that song. Like, I don't even, if God doesn't move, it's very, very strange. You know what I'm saying? So I
right.
I think I love that one the most.
Yeah, I'd be like, you know, is this mic on? What's going on? Why is
right,
it?
Right.
Why don't we film in this place right now?
Yeah. Yep.
I know you said you played the piano. Did you do any production on the album?
I didn't do any production, man. I try to, you know, I'm not as confident in playing the piano as I probably should be, because, you know, my singers and everybody are always like, man, you need to do a set where you're just sitting on the piano. You know, things move a lot, like more fluid when I'm sitting on the piano, because I know exactly where I want to go, where to go, what to do. But I'm just not as confident to sit in front of, you know, a couple thousand people and do that. So I'm just like, okay, I'll stay away from that, let you guys handle it, and I'll just worry about sharing the phone.
With the event, or, you know, I don't know if you're doing a promo tour or anything like that right now, but where can we expect to see you, you know, now or in the near future, as far as performances or festivals or anything like that?
I'll be in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. They're having a revival there, and I wish it's at Rose Hill Church in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and I'll be there with Bishop Walker. And actually, the night before I'm there, William Murphy is there. And the night before that, Shayna Wilson is there. So they're talking about doing revival for real. And then the next weekend, on the 26th, I'll be in Virginia Beach. July 26th, I'll be in Virginia Beach with Jessica Reedy and Mally Music. So those are two right off the top of my head that I can think of that, man, I really would, you know, because I'm a fan of those artists as well. So, like, you know, if you want to come out, man, those are good events right there to come out on. July 26th in Virginia Beach. And also this weekend on July 19th in Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
And I even said that you are a fan of both Jessica Reedy and Mally Music. Who would you say are your top three favorite gospel artists?
I would say Israel Halsey, Donnie McClurkin, and because he's just so consistent. And actually, I've like fallen in love with the ministry of Tasha Cobbs. Like, she carries a weighty power about herself.
How can your fans and supporters and everyone who's Team Todd Dulaney stay updated with you, find out all the latest news from you, your next move, everything like that?
We try to keep you posted on Facebook and on Twitter. Like, I'm heavy on Facebook and Twitter. I'm probably on there too much. But my Twitter handle is at Todd Dulaney, at TODDDULANEY. And then on Facebook, you can just type in the search for my name, Todd Dulaney, TODDDULANEY. And everything is always there. We always keep people posted with not only just the event times and places, but pictures. If you're not able to make a video, you know, we try to keep it really, really fresh and keep it going.
What advice did you give to people to kind of stay relevant in the gospel industry specifically?
I would say right away to just be yourself. You know, we have so many clones of, like, people that, you know, imitate what they see. And I think that's where the disconnection is in gospel music, is that we want to see more originals. We want to see more of people just be themselves. We want to hear new voices. You know, we have Kim Burrell already. Somebody please let go. You know, let Kim Burrell be Kim Burrell. And then, you know, if we could just invent some new voices and people just be themselves and let God use them the way they are, I believe that we see more uniqueness and we see more power. Because, you know, it's easy. I mean, not easy. I wouldn't say it's easy. But for me, the power of God comes in where you're being yourself. I can't do a song the way someone else does it and it come off the same way as they articulate it. I have to do it the way that it's in me. So I would just say, just be yourself, man. Be yourself.
Have you decided on the next single from the album yet?
The next single is actually already out. It's called No Other Name. And actually, we're getting ready. I'm getting ready in the process over the next, you know, month or so to release a new single from the upcoming album. You know how, because Pulling Me Thru has been out for years, even though Universal right. Montana just released it. You know, I'm getting ready for the second album. The second album is already like 95% complete, and we have a new single from that album, which is called Trust in You. And I really, 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 really think you guys are going to like it.
Oh, okay. So did you decide on a title yet for the upcoming album?
No, not yet. I'm still trying to let it sit and see what happens. But I know that first single is going to be Trust in You. And then after that, I don't know. Why, you got some ideas, man?
No, because usually I can get it out of people when I'm interviewing, because usually somebody, you know, they'll say, we haven't decided yet, but I think it might be, or something like that. So I know you got some titles that's on the cutting room floor that you haven't decided on yet. So
man,
if you could just
throw
off the top
around.
Of your head right now, what would you want to name the album? What would you kind of see it being named?
Wow, man. I don't think you're going to be able to get one today, man, because I just don't know. I've been through so much, man. I've been through so much since the first album, so, man, I don't know. It's got to be something that has to do with how much I've come through this mess that I've gone through.
Well, there you go. That could be a title right there. I've been through so much.
Something like that, man.
You have, like, a projected date when you think you guys might release the album, or kind of what part of the year?
Well, if it's not at the end of the year, it'll be definitely at the top of the year. So we're looking to meet this single in to either the end of the year, depending on when we release the single, I believe is when we release the album. So if we get a chance to release the single over the next 2 weeks or something like that, then I would say that we'll be able to release the album towards the end of this year. If not, a little bit later, then we'll release it at the very top of the year.
All right, cool. Well, Todd, when that time comes, you tell Tracy that you want to do another interview.
Man,
Mike Jones with uGospel to give us that exclusive for the project.
Definitely, man. Hey, man, and my wife and I get so many emails from uGospel, man.
Yeah, we got it.
You guys
on top of the game.
You keep us up to date, man.
Uh-huh. That's what we do. We love to do it. We do what we love.
Yes,
but, man, I want to thank you for this interview today. I enjoyed our conversation. Definitely looking forward to that album coming out. And, again, man, I just thank you for taking the time out for this interview.
Man, thanks a lot, Mike. I appreciate you, dog.
No problem, man. Have a blessed day.